Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. You guys must be wondering, what is this beautiful photo doing here? So, this is the photo of the Milky Way galaxy which our solar system lives inside in. But don't you know, there's much more bigger than the galaxy itself? Yes, there's the universe, the observable universe, which is the limit of our scientists to observe the universe. Because light, before the observable limit, cannot enter the Earth. So, today I want to present to you all on my final project. My name is Ahmad Ifan bin Nazaruddin and my matric number is 1170269. My supervisor name is Dr. Muhammad Mus'ab bin Anas. The title is Development of Astronomical Unit from Barycentric to Galactic Rest Frame, Python Programming. So, this will be my plan of talk. You can skip if you want. So, for the introduction, space is the immense explorable area discovered since people saw stars in the sky for guidance during the early days. Light is also information that scientists can use to identify a star's position, speed, and some material properties. Relative velocity and the position is very easily obtained when viewing a star with a regular telescope. However, the data gathered uses ICRS instead of GSR frame, which I will be explaining later. Our solar system have a barycenter, which is the center for ICRS frame. Python with SRP packages will be used for unit conversion. Further development for the unit will assist people in the future of space exploration, especially from the universe scale. So, this is the photo of the barycenter. As you can see, the Earth has its own orbit and the Moon has its own orbit. So, the barycenter is the center. So, imagine this. This is the center and Earth revolves around the orbit and Moon revolves around the orbit. So, the motion will be like this. Each of them have their own orbit. So that the next picture is for the general coordinate. As you can see, the Earth has a center and the stars, there's a star. This is the same as latitude and longitude. So for the galactocentric, we use galactic center as the center for GCRS or galactocentric or GSR, galactic standing of rest. But for the general one is the ICRS, barycentric, as you can see in the second photo. Earth acts as the center. The problem statement is ICRS, local standard of rest, widely used as standard reference frame in major national space researches. Galactic standard of rest is uncommon as it uses the galaxy center as reference frame due to no nearby objects to be compared. When comparing to outer galactic objects, it will be an issue due to our galaxy and the objects having their own motion. The platform that is easily accessible to those objects is GSR frame from ICRS frame unit conversion. For the significance of the study, it will provide the foundation for other researchers in pursuing the exploration of far distance celestial objects, not only in stars, also in exoplanets. Python is only one of the platforms to pursue the development of unit conversion within the frames, so there will be more platforms that will provide this unit conversion. The complexity of multiple reference frames shows us how great the universe is. As a Muslim, we can relate the Almighty Allah's great knowledge and control over the universe. The objectives will be three. The first one is to determine the radial velocity in galactic standard of rest, which is galactocentric. The second one is transform positions and velocities to and from a galactocentric frame. And the last one is to identify the anomalies in using the astronomical unit conversion in Python. For the method, I will be using data samples from SIMBAD, a server, an online server which has stellar objects in it. It's acquired in increasing stellar distance respect to Earth. So the data gathered will be increasing from closest to Earth to the furthest to Earth. But from the SIMBAD, there will be only four key values, which is RV, radial velocity, RA, right extension, DEC, declination angle, and P, parallax. For the method, I will be using desktop PC with Intel i5 at 3.4 GHz with 12 GB of RAM. For the calculation for radial velocity in GSR frame via formula, this is the formula. For the first objective is to convert RV radial velocity into GSR frame. First one is I will inquire multiple data from SIMBAD and then insert SRP package in Jupyter notebook and then insert a stellar data with the trig values and then try to run the coding, ensure there's no error, And then, the new radial velocity unit in the new GSR frame is collected. But then, we have to calculate it back into a GSR formula. Okay. For the second objective, is to transform positions and velocities to and from a GSR frame. It's actually the same from objective 1. Instead, first stellar object with all four values, radial velocity, right extension, declination, and parallax, and then try to run the coding, ensure no error, and then the unit is obtained in three vectors and radial velocity. And then depiction of four rings, verifying the successful transformation. That's the output. So, for the third objective, to identify the anomalies, we have to repeat the first sample to 27 for objective 1. And then, we plot the graph with two frames, one with ICRS, another one with GSR. So, and then we will analyze the data by relating GCRS and ICRS radial velocities. Then, we will conclude the relation between the frames. For the results and discussion, the first table is showing the first sample, which is Alpha Centauri with right extension angle, declination angle, and radial velocity. Where the second table is showing there's three set stellar objects, but with three radial velocity values. The first one is using ICRS frame, and the second one is GSR frame, but using Python, using Astropy packages. And the third one is GSR frame, but using formula shown in the method. For the graph, as you can see, radial velocity ICRS and versus GSR and the difference. For the purple is using ICRS frame and blue is using GSR frame, and the pink is the difference between GSR and ICRS frame. But as you can see, the number sample taken increased with stellar distance, but there's no relation when distance increased with the radial velocity regardless the frame change. From the graph, we can see with rising stellar distance, despite difference varies, it can be implied that the unit conversion is very likely to be accurate than the radial velocity in GSR obtained via formula. From the table 1 and 2, for the table 2, as you can see, there's some radial velocity, there's a negative value which shows in such direction. It's going away from Earth, it's positive, and negative, it's moving towards Earth. Okay. For the table 3, this is the second method. First sample, using proper motion radial right extension and declination for proper motion and parallax and radial velocity. Okay, and the table 4 will show the result. There's three components XYZ and three galactic coordinates GC1, GC2, and GC3. There's new radial velocity in three components. We can verify the transformation is possible from the GSR frame. So figure 4 shows that the velocity of the ring are identical and valid on the same curve. X component is opposite of the galactocentric radial velocity, resulting in galactocentric instance to see the 3D XYZ velocity components. The last graph is rings of observable coordinates are visualized. Transformation also works in the opposite direction. It is also useful for transforming simulated or theoretical data to observable quantities. We have converted proper motion component to Cartesian velocity components using Astropy units. So for the conclusion, results obtained might differ from calculated due to peculiar motion. Peculiar motion is an occurrence where many objects affecting the stellar object due to the limitation of regular telescope on undetected ones. So there's unknown objects close to the stellar object. So that's what we call peculiar motion. So for this method of converting astropy needs to add more methods in order to eliminate the randomness and create a clear new relation between reference frames, ICRS and GSR frame. Transformation of positions and velocities in and from GSR frame is possible via Python, by shown in the graph, the circle one. For the galaxy itself, it's not stationary but shifts due to the gravity of all the overdense material clumps and also the loss of gravity from all the less dense areas. This is the references. Thank you for watching the video. You can contact me if you want. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.